Hey, well, this is Jeff with Final Boss Editing, doing writing this week instead of editing. So yeah, a little bit of a change of pace. But yeah, so today, the project I'm working on is a 12-page screenplay in 1 week. It's for a competition called 168. Should be a lot of fun, just to write and kind of put this stuff together. I kind of have the goal written out on the left side. I'll actually make sure that I'm showing the right screen on both sides here. Let me just remove this. Loglines. Perfect. Shrink that to size. Awesome. Sorry about the little technical issue there. Try to scoot that up a little bit higher so you can actually see the screen. Awesome. Cool. So what you can see here is have a few loglines written out. What I'm doing now is I'm kind of going in and seeing, okay, which ones do I want to keep? Which ones do I want to remove? I had a few friends throw some votes in and say, hey, they liked this one or they didn't like the other one. So what I'm doing is going based off those votes. My bandwidth may be a little bit slow. I see it turning red here. Oof. Yeah, really laggy. But see if I can free up some bandwidth by turning off connections. But yeah. Anyways, going through the log lines, trying to find the best. So I'm going to do process of elimination, remove the ones I don't like, and keep the ones I do. So if you're watching, feel free to throw a comment on, and I will keep an eye out for it. And if you like one of the log lines that I'm about to cut, let me know because I'm about to cut it. So I'm going to throw on some music, get some work. This music is by US Killbotics. They're really cool guys. And they said we can play this on the stream. So, yay. What I'm doing is I'm just cutting out the ones that I don't, that either I didn't really feel, so I'm kind of just getting the ones that I don't feel great out. Punk rocker apprentices for masterpieces. They're showing them how to truly enjoy. Megan is reading aloud. An alchemist works on his greatest invention, the Philosopher's Stone, but realizes that in order to complete it, he'll have to use his own life as the final ingredient. And this is kind of about accepting work and not becoming like obsessed with work and stuff like that. So, managing partner firm dies from overwork, leaving his position open. Two of his underlings vie for his job, not realizing that getting a promotion could cost their souls. I those first two. So I did the first two. I guess I wrote the first. Young punk rocker saves his master, a classic guitar maker obsessed with perfection, from his obsession with work by showing him how to truly enjoy music. Yeah, I like that one. Startup co-founder's child waits for him from home and confronts him with obsession. After the company's IPO celebration, newly minted millionaire is held at gunpoint by a kid trying to get some food from his parents. This one actually got a lot of votes, even though it's probably not my favorite. So I'm gonna be like minus one. Let's see. Any comments here? Sorry, someone just asked me if I've been deciding on my log line, and I'm like, yes, I actually am, like right now. Yeah, I'm gonna close the door because I think there's some people playing FIFA. Hopefully that doesn't hurt my Wi-Fi more than it's already hurt. But sadly I can't plug in because people are milling around upstairs. Okay. So, okay. Okay, so the Alchemist one I like. Managing partner to firm, dice from overwork. That's kind of like an Ivan Ilyich. But from like the actual, his co-worker side. Young punk rocker apprentice saves his master, classical guitar maker. I kind of like that. That one gets me. I only got one vote, and I don't like the Alchemist one, which I do like too, because I love the Alchemist world, but we'll see. After company's IPO celebration, newly minted millionaire is held up at gunpoint by a kid trying to get food for his parents. That one's kind of curious. Given the choice between a startup becoming a small, profitable business, the next thing is Facebook. There's not enough conflict in that. It's not like it's like, no, I can't do that. Even though I have two X's. The company is running out of money and the founder has two options. Close the doors and get a normal day job. Hey, Foxy Lady. I'm making this selection right now, Foxy Lady 17. So pretty much what I'm doing is I'm looking at log lines, all the votes that people put in. Yours are up top here. Thank you for your contribution. But all the votes are on the little X's. So if they got three X's, that's three votes. If they got two X's, two votes. So yeah, what I'm doing is I'm process of eliminating. So I'm kind of taking away the ones I definitely don't like, and then working my way from that. So we'll see. It's my bandwidth is showing like red and yellow, so it may or may not be good or bad. Let me see. Also mention that. Okay, so then a new company is running out of money and the founder has two options. Close the doors and get a normal day job, or kill one of the leads and pay the company's bills with insurance dollars. That's probably a little bit too far-fetched. I'm gonna pull that out. A jingle writer for an advertising company is turned down when he goes to sell a classical song he considers his true masterpiece. Let's see if we have some more votes coming in. Okay. Heartbroken and considering suicide, he's saved by suddenly listening to that campaign. That one is kind of... I'm gonna hold on to that. It's similar to number three, but I kind of like that one. A board support rep who fixes computers by day uses phone skills to talk to the CEO of a struggling company off the ledge of the building. I don't know. Eight is derp. Let's see what else we got. Any more comments from our awesome commenters? It's a bit delayed, but not too bad. Sweet. Okay. Yeah, it's. I think the Aiden and the other guys are playing FIFA online, so they may be kicking my bandwidth. Those darn kids. Anyways, the jungle rider. Okay, jungle rider. Okay, got the doctor on board. Support rep and fixes computers by day. I just don't know if that one has much of a. Of like an edge to it. Thanks, Foxy Lady. That's probably really what it is. It's not FIFA. So the board support rep thing. I'm gonna take that out. Hey, what up? What up, Vic? You can see my live stream going through the Logline. So I'm going process of elimination. Eclectic. Well, it's just like a startup t-shirt. Come on. What's eclectic about that? But pretty much what I'm doing is I'm taking away the ones I definitely don't want, and then I'm trying to figure out the ones that I do like. So that's kind of what I'm doing. And Foxy Lady is also online, and she's the lady friend, so she's been helping with my thought process. A gifted watchmaker in a war-torn country is put to work on making guns. He excels at it, but struggles to find new pieces needed for the job. Okay, so now we have about six, not including Derp or Furp. Okay, so what's the next ones to cut? An alchemist works on his greatest invention, the Philosopher's Stone. Still like that one. I like the Ivan Ilyich one. I don't know how to really visualize that and to make it something that's like really baked in with conflict, or like I can't really think of like a context to put it in yet. So this one may be minus one. Like I think, you know, the Alchemist one kind of comes baked in with like scenes, stuff that I can see, and then this one is a little bit more vague still. Let me see. The young punk rocker apprentice stages master, classical guitar maker. I like this one. I kind of actually already thought through some of the scenes, so I'm going to go for the Alchemist. Yeah, that's true. I'm debating, like, because I've, you know, kind of thought about that world before, and I would obviously do, like, a different take than what I was thinking of for this, but I'm debating on whether I should just kind of go completely with, like, something I haven't even... I guess modern day is, like, a world. Like, if it's, like, modern day, it's, like, a world you've already thought about, so I guess that's kind of redundant, defies the purpose. I'm thinking, I like the, I think this one's rings true to me. The Jingle Rider one, I think, is just a shadow of that one. Songs you consider this a true masterpiece. Though that does have kind of like, yeah, I don't think I want that. Gifted Watchmaker, I don't think that's that good. Man, it was really the top two. Still the ones I like the most. The top three. Go for the Alchemist. See, I'm like on the fence. Nearly Meant to Millionaire is held at gunpoint by a kid to get food for his parents and uses his welfare. It's kind of sappy. It's true. I agree. Those are kind of the ones I'm really torn. Is that one or the Alchemist one, I think? Because I like the student. Yeah. Well, here, what I can do is I'll pitch you guys what I think each of them will be, or like what I'm visualizing, and then you guys can say which one you like better. So, picture this. So with the Alchemist one, I see it opening with, you know, the Alchemist and his assistant, because you want someone at least there to kind of be like the devil's advocate, the person who's like either vying for the opposite perspective, going into like some dark corridor, and they're like, and like the assistant's like, are you sure you want to do this? Are you sure you want to go into this, like, you know, like do this? And like he's like, no, it's cool. It's like some back alley of San Francisco. They go through, there's like a lot of really old, like, you know, kind of grandma type, like ladies, sort of like Chinatown. I still laid those, so wait for me. Okay. Well, yeah, I'm at about 2,000 kbps, so it's a little bit slow. So then pretty much what happens will be they kind of go into this dark building. There's always, like, really, like, weird old people. And they kind of, like, are negotiating with this person for, like, this formula. And there's something like, oh, I have, like, my piece of it. What's your piece? And, like, the old guy starts, like, laughing maniacally. And he's like, it's you. It's you. And then, like, you know, they kind of have to go make the decision, like, right there on the spot. And then I was envisioning at the end that, like, the apprentice person is kind of, like, more... You know, this is a bit of a weird song. It's a little bit too, like, too much stuff. So, yeah, that's kind of what I'm on the fence about. So, like, then the apprentice, I kind of, like, is like, no, don't. And then you kind of have to have that conflict there in front of all the crazy old people and, like, this weird alchemy setting in the modern day. The other one is more of, you know, you'd kind of probably open with, like, this really beautiful guitar. You kind of hear it getting tuned, and then, like, a hammer just, like, crashes through the guitar, and it, like, rips it in half. And, like, the old guy's like, that's a crap instrument. You did a terrible job. Go make another one. And, like, you know, it's, like, kind of this obsession over, like, making the perfect instrument. And then, you know, he's like, well, look, we're just trying to run a business here. Like, you know, what's going on? And then, you know, he kind of, like, salvages the guitar, like, puts it back together. And then, like, the old guy goes to, like, a concert with, like, the young man. Or, like, you know, like, he's like, well, come see my concert tonight. And then there, like, you see him playing the salvaged guitar, and it's, like, beautiful. And then that kind of changes the old guy's heart. So those are kind of, like, it's kind of tough to compress such a big concept into such, like, a small, like, package, I guess. But those are kind of the ways I'm thinking about breaking this up. Does that make sense? Does that help give any more context into those two kind of combating ideas? And also the managing partner to firm one is, I kind of like that just because, like, I think the irony of, like you know, Ivan Ilyich, right, is, like, this guy dies, and the first thing they talk about is, like, who's going to get his job? And you like The Alchemist better still? Okay, like, with the creepy old people and, like, having to make the choice right there whether you're going to die for this, like, big thing, this thing you're going to build. Versus the heartfelt old fart and stuff, no? Yeah, just loves their sci-fi. That's also a sci-fi skew. Yeah, I like the managing partner one too. I think those are... Gee, these three are tough. You like the two? Yeah, I think they all are. Yeah, I think they all kind of have an edge. Because I like the. So I think. Well, let's. I'm making this write down what I think the pluses and minuses are. So this is like irony. Guy dies, and the first thing people do. His job. The second one, you know. The second thing is, you know, it's baked in conflict. Two people want the same thing. I think the thing I like about this is it shows the potential end result. I don't think I got one today, Vic. They may have put it in my inbox, but I haven't seen it. So the baked in conflict. Hey, what up, Moocher? How's it going? Welcome back. So pretty much what we're doing is we had a list. I wish I just deleted like a ton of log lines. But we had a list of like 10 different log lines, and here, I'll see if I can do a quick replay here. So we had like all these log lines, and then through kind of process of elimination and having people vote, we took it down to 3. So now what we're doing is out of these 3 kind of winning log lines, trying to say, okay, what are the pluses and minuses in each one? Which one hits the theme the best? And then probably what I'll do after this is just start outlining, you know, actually what, you know, the plot will be tonight. And then tomorrow I'll probably start on the first draft, which hopefully you guys are around to join on as well. So yeah, I mean, I think, so the thing I kind of did was I kind of walked through like a really basic pitch of each of these. And then what I'm kind of doing now is trying to just weigh the pluses and minuses of each, just kind of writing it out. So, look, the other comments on theme work. Oh, maybe it got put in my spam. So Vic, 168. I don't know, man. Let me see. I'm not seeing it. Yeah, I didn't get it. Do you mind forwarding that to me, Vic? Because that'd be awesome to see. So we have the gear here, at least in the section. But anyways, I'm wondering starting to consider others. Like the new tester one. Is that your comments on the theme work, Vic? Or is that like what they did in fact quit their day job, matching with the fact that Ecclesiastes is really viewed as man's wisdom, setting up for a pretty interesting ride? It could be a beautiful story, not to mention nowadays. It's all good. Okay, so then got the vote for Mutra on this. So I like it. So what I'll probably do is I'll just like outline kind of the basic story on each of these, and like there's like a very bare bones framework, and then kind of the benefits and the potential benefits and like advantages and stuff of each. So that's irony, guys. Faith and conflict. People want the same thing. And this is, I think, what you were talking about, Moocher, in the last night, where we were saying, like, hey, we need to see the fail case. Someone died because of work. That's mistakes. Apologies to coworkers. Yeah, I think that's true. I think my thoughts on the theme work and kind of my response to that is, like, I think that a lot of people in the biblical narrative, like, you know, quit work to join evangelism, and then that became their work. But I also think that, like, you know, work done in, like, the proper context can also be very evangelical. So those are kind of, like, the ways I think about that balance of work and saying, oh, yeah, like, you know, there are people who did, like, hey, I'm leaving this and going evangelism, but I think, like, you know, God made Adam to, like, tend the garden. Like, there's something that's evangelical just about doing a really great job on something. So I think that's kind of where my stance lies. So I'll probably still stick with something in, like, the work context and not have that, like, that story leap. Because I think for me, what I at least grapple with the most, just being, you know, kind of honest, is, like, in the work context, is saying, hey, like, I care about my work. I, you know, love what I do, but then it's like, how do I not make that an idol? And I think that's kind of where I see this really coming through. It's true. So true. You love your job, you'll never go to work again. It's true. Yeah, sometimes, you know, I think that's, like, the nature of, like, the fallen world is, like, sometimes, even if it's a great job and it's what God's calling you to do, sometimes it's just going to suck and it's still not going to be fun. But I think that's kind of, like, the cool interplay is, like, we have that hope for, like, you know, even for, like, you know, this is a really great story. I'm going to type it in the comments. It's by Tolkien. Foxy lady will probably laugh because she's heard me say this a million times, but that's, like, a really interesting story about kind of how, that yearning to, like, build something, like, within humans is good, and, like, it's, like, how through God it's, like, really where that's fulfilled. So that's kind of, like, you know, my take on that theological point, Vic. So let me know if you agree or disagree. I don't know if that's, like, always the best context, but yeah, if you love your job, you're not here to work again. True story. You need to see the fail case. Someone dies because of work. I always do, like, a quick, like, outline. Foxy lady's laughing because I like this story a ton. So I think it's, like, you know, it's like a well-dressed old man. So, like, he's just, like, sitting on a subway, like, working on his laptop, and he's just like, derp. How about the beautiful, interesting guitar, but the sounds suffer from design. The frame breaks out in the workshop. I like that. So it's like, returning to the beginning. Maybe he had that first guitar that just was amazing. That reminds me of a really awesome short story, and it's like a page and a half, so I would, like, also, along with the Tolkien one, really recommend it. It has some swear words and stuff, so if you're okay with that, just a heads up. But it's called Bullet to the Brain by Tobias Wolff. And you can probably find it on Google or something, but that's an absolutely amazing story about just kind of this like, it was kind of something similar where it was this, like, this editor that had this deep passion for language and writing, and, like, how at the end of his life he kind of returns to it. And I thought that was, like, that's a very good catch on that theme. Let me see the fail case. Someone dies because of work. Let's see, of course. He's working on the subway, kills over to stop. The water fountain, two guys talking at the water fountain is, like, kind of a stereotypical thing to do next. Maybe it would be, like, both in the boss's office. Or it's, if you challenge them to a guitar battle, you bust on the classic. Yeah. Epic guitar battles, yeah. All So I think, but that actually brings up an interesting point, was like having a clear antagonist here if possible. I think that's one of the drawbacks of this one, to be honest, is I don't know if this, in at least the logline form, has a really solid antagonist there. So that's interesting. Maybe I'll actually do, there's a really great tool or just like way of thinking about it called GSU for like goal, stakes, urgency. So the goal, which is like two people vying for the same goal, what happens if they lose or get it. And then like the urgency, like why it has to be now. So then we could be like, hey, we'll just get the job. Stakes. If I don't get this, I don't like boss. Boss is making action by end of day. The good guy here has a family that he needs to. Like maybe it's like a good job, and like it sort of like goes back to like the prompts where it's like it's a good job, and he could just be okay doing it. But then he's like kind of just yearning for more. His boss making decisions, good guy here has a family that he needs to spend time with. Oh, I think that's the urgency actually. This is like the last dude is dead. This is actually this is a band called it was actually just straight from this person's SoundCloud. So this is a band called the US Killbotics. So I realized that I couldn't play music on Twitch without getting permission, so I actually emailed this guy who I've liked his music for forever, and I was like, can I play your music on my Twitch stream? And he's like, yeah. So I'm just playing down his SoundCloud playlist. This is actually just one musician. I can turn a little bit down though. A lot of our career graduates collect to do anything love it, depending on keeping the lights on. Yeah. And maybe that's even something you play in with like the guitar one, right? Where it is like, how do you be and I think that element also is in the Alchemist one, where it is like, you know, loves alchemy. Which why making, that's why being the greatest is that much more important to him. What else can we bring in here? Mission's greatest innovation, philosopher stone, listening to his own life as the final ingredient. So I kind of like well-dressed man, okay, urgency by end of day, outline, office, guy. Ooh, guy gets a call at home. Like he has to like leave home. Like he's hanging with his kids, and like sleeks and like and drives to the office to get the news. At like 2 a.m. And like the managing partner's like, fundraising's coming up, we have to hit this metric, I don't care, like one of you's gonna do it or not. And then maybe they're both like have to do like a showdown that night. Like the two like directors going for the VP title have to throw down that night. Simple act of someone watching something. Maybe that's something I could work into the guy's piece at home, right? Because then it is like, maybe it's just like that, like bliss. He's with his family after like a long day, And then he gets that call that, like, the boss died or whatever it is. And then he has to go back to the office. All right, and then obviously that's, like, more the director and character development, too. But Vic, the guy above, excuse me, the guy who commented, up here in Kingdom Ministry is an amazing director. So you can check him out and give him a follow. But he's a phenomenal director, and that's actually a really good suggestion. He may be interested in that comment too, I think. I do kind of like this music though, even though it's random. let's see. Alchemist works in the greatest innovation. Okay. The night to get the job in the morning. Then maybe there's like a. I like the little smiley faces on Twitch. Respect! Well, this guy, like, the musician, US Killbotics, like, he's, like, the coolest dude. He made his own video game. I have mad respect for this guy, so I'll represent. Even though there's, like, you know, three people to represent too, but represent. Alchemist works in his greatest innovation, the Philosopher's Stone. Okay. So I think I've kind of baked out what 2 is going to look like in a bigger sense. So now I want to look at like 1 and 3 and see which of them has the best story structure. So now I'm kind of moving away from evaluating based off the idea and just to say, okay, what can I hang a 12-page story on that will be articulate, that will have forward drive, that will have goals, that will have character interaction. That's like from like Duke Nukem, right? Yeah, or the Doom. Oh my gosh, good game. All right, so for the Alchemist one, let's do the benefits. And then... I think this is like the mystical... He does all these remixes. I don't like. As much as I used to like Rammstein in high school, I don't like it anymore. This one. Sweet. Okay, I like the middle. Like, so I think the thing about fantasy is you can really get those concepts that you're trying to define and, like, make them visual, which is nice in film because everything's visual. But, you know, I think it also kind of, just going more abstract, you have to set up more time for world building. So that's, like, time to world build is kind of the cost there. Yeah, that face is the is the Rammstein face. Yes, very true.
Du hast das German.
Let me see. Like the mystical element allows for metaphor, time to world build. What are the other kind of benefits? I think it brings in the same level of stakes. Like, you know, it's your life. Allows for sacrifice. So the way I saw this story playing out is, like, the assistant tries to, like, jump in and, like, put his life in for, like, to make the Philosopher's Stone in place of, like, his master. And that's when the master, like, stops him and saying, oh, I've taken this way too far. Allows for sacrifice. There's blood that needs to be paid. For greatness. All right, later. Cool, I'm out. Talk to you soon. Hugs and rock and roll. Later. Sorry, I didn't even notice. Later, Vic. Talk to you soon. There's blood that needs to be paid. Like, mystical element allows for a metaphor, time to world build. You can make a cool world. Can make a much more colorful spectrum than just an office. And the way I saw this playing out, like the... I'll just do GSE first. So goal is complete. You've gotta pay with your own life. Yeah, it's... I think that urgency is weaker. You could choose any time period on that one. It could be steampunk and Wild West. Digs up the stone and gets too powerful. Keeps showing through the ages. That's true. One of the reasons I'm considering still keeping this like modern day is one, because I just like the idea that there's alchemists running around. But two is I think Kingdom Ministry, probably wants to work together to maybe produce one of these at some point. So the more fantasy stuff, the harder, the more expensive it gets to make. But I do like that. So it's like, it is, I probably should at least just bring that in and see, like, you know, right now this is a writing competition and, you know, not, you know, a production. So like time period is flexible. Yeah. GSU, the Philosopher's Stone, you gotta pay with your own life, now or never. Yeah, I think the urgency is weak, because if they're getting the component from these people, maybe when we work through this story right now, it'll be a little bit more crystallized. Interesting. Just gotta plug forward. I'm like, oh man, these are all kind of weird, but I gotta keep going forward. You can't look back when you're writing. You gotta get to the first draft. That's true. Just like this, like, epic, yeah, I like it. Yeah, I gotta get my props game on. I'm not as like good at my arts and crafts as I used to be. I gotta step it up, for real. Let me see. The story. Okay, so then this will start. To talk the master out of going into a sketchy SF building. Talk to Master Growing in such SF building. These songs, though. Yeah. It's true. These things are coming in hot. Just hang out. I'm sure there's probably one. There's probably like an upcoming meteor shower on Google somewhere. I'll just walk out to the desert. Go get my supplies. I love it. Assistant's trying to attack the master into a sketchy SF building. Okay, so once they get to the building, we see potions. Building. Ancient. It's interesting. So, like, with the... Yeah, I think the race element's interesting. I think the thing I'm seeing that's kind of coming is going to be a little bit of a risk for this one is... everything looks like everything else. I wouldn't worry too much about that. But, there's always... Somebody's always, kind of touched at least some concepts before. But... I don't know, I think my biggest concern with the Alchemist one is like really building in that conflict and that kind of trade-off. They strike a deal, if we get the stone, we get half the buff stone, it's actually a meteor. Okay, so it's either, like, we can put a race element, we can pull the screen, we get half. And they... Yeah, because then it would just be like kind of just talking it out. Don't want it to be just talking it out. Maybe it's finding the old man for his final piece. So, like, they both, like, obsess over finding this guy. And then... Ah! I like that. Yeah. Actually, it's ironic. I wrote, because I was playing around in the Alchemist world before, and I did, like, a radio drama where, like, the Black Tulip was, like, one of, like, the, like, you know, like, the, what is it they call it? The thing that everyone's looking for, the MacGuffin. But, yeah, I think I like it. I think it needs an engine like that. Yes. Wait a second. These are epic magical seeds? Wonderful. But it's like, I like that, because then it's like the like tons of bonsai everywhere. And this perfect flower. And it's like this dim room and like... Yeah, so I think if I go with this one, the structure will have to be going on the search for this old man, and then once we get there, it's like time to choose. Yeah, has to have more of the search. Yeah. Idea. Okay, so I'm gonna steer away from the Alchemist for a little bit and look on the third logline. Because I think this was the one I actually had baked out in another draft a little bit. And I'll kind of bring that to the side just so I can use that as a benchmark. It's dim and you can swear that little clean men are moving around. Ooh, that'd be pretty tight. I like that. I like it because I think that's good, like, you know, like... See, that's the thing. I mean, I love, like, I mean, the reason I gravitate to the Alchemist story is that it has that, like, world that's, like, so vivid already baked in. You cut out for a bit. Oh, so pretty much what I'm doing now is I'm going to outline the third one, and then I'm going to make a call. Just, like, very briefly, because, you know, I can't belabor a point too much. Even though I probably already am. I'm, like... very meticulous about these things, so sadly it comes at a price. Potential boredom. let me see. Yeah, I don't know. It looks like my bandwidth is okay. It's kind of in this range of like, you know, red and yellow. It's like kind of like flashing between red and yellow. So it looks like my bandwidth is doing okay. But if it keeps cutting out, hopefully I'll get all our roommates to stop playing FIFA. I'm just kidding. I don't think I could physically do that with a sledgehammer. It's getting too crazy right now. They're too invested. So I think in this one, like the benefits, student master dynamic. Student young people he meets. He's really cerebral. As an adult, he discovers the joy of music through the young people he meets by taking his child to concerts. Granddaddy Beatbox. I like it. Grandpappy Beatbox on the ones and twos. I love this story, but it really strictly brought up like a prodigy and discovers the joy of music. So I like that. So it's like, how do you... Who is the... this person get enjoyment truly? How does he think he'll get it? Not up. But really needs. Yeah, I think that's like the kind of the interplay of like want and need. The concept of work is art is a bit slower stated approach to the prompt. Let me see. GSU. I'm trying to think who would be like the gold person. I don't know if a little pair is constantly working on practicing the guild, then not to wonder. But is it fun? It's true. It's like more of like almost like a coaching relation. Like maybe the student doesn't realize that it's truly good. Concept of work as art is a bit less overstated in this approach. Okay, the goal probably would be like, you know, student is concert. Master is and then the stakes. That would be like concert, but broke the harder than I thought it would be. Picking up a good idea in like 7 days. Urgency is Oh, I see. Maybe one day the music teacher has a crack team of world-class players. Screw it. I'm gonna go to a crazy one. That's true. Yeah. The students are the obsessed ones, and the master is the one that finally is really healthy. Standing of work. Then I'll just do a quick outline of this, and then we'll decide. So this is the way I envisioned it, and obviously there's probably other ways to crack this particular egg. Young Rockstar Record Apprentice saves his master. Classic Guitar Maker. Okay. Did I already write that line in? Hey, Julie. Judy. Sorry. Hey, Judy. How's it going? Good to see ya. For some just general context, we're looking at kind of three top log lines that came out of that brainstorming yesterday, distilling them into a basic story structure, and then trying to pick which of those three story structures seems the most resilient and the most likely to kind of really have kick. Think of the cultural clash in the Japanese season. Okay, Mr. Going through the students and all jealous. Think of the cultural clash. Free playing because of loving. I like that. It's like that. Compare with. Maybe that could be like the null hypothesis, like, you know, with our team that. I think it's watching a musician winning a Grammy and being the Interesting. Music is not a competition. It's true. And maybe, I think, that's actually really interesting, because I think in this particular prompt, in my mind, I was probably gravitating more towards the building, like, a instrument part, but maybe it is, like, hey, that performance element is probably much more where that conflict truly happens, where it is, like, you know, that's where a lot of that really rubber hits the road as far as, like, people just, like, obsessing over these performances and going crazy. Which is, that happens, man. It's crazy. A few of my buddies used to be in music and they quit because it just, like, drove them crazy. But it's sad because they were absolutely phenomenal musicians, but, should we make this more performance-oriented? What could be the Okay, so then it's like phone was off, this is crap. Maybe it's like the writing. Oh, maybe it's like a teacher student where it is like maybe tears up the kids' music that he wrote. And he's like, this is nonsense. True. You can't go wrong with T-Swift, man. I wish I could change my soundtrack to that. But sadly, I do not have T-Swift's permission to play her music. But I'm sure she's a pro, man. I'm actually going to check something real fast here, see how we're doing. Nice. Okay, master tone was off. It's crap. Sounds like everything else you've made. Tears the kids up. I can kind of bold this so if someone's jumping in later, they can see like what we're actually editing. Punker Rocker Apprentices, okay. Beautiful Car gets smashed. Master's tone was off. This was crap. Student says it doesn't have to be perfect. So this is like the theme part, and they kind of argue. The master, like, you know, some moral comes up. You changed, man. Poor T Swift. She had a rough upbringing with this strict teacher. Morality comes up because of this. Ceremony becomes because of this. Okay. Comes up because of this. Oh, maybe the kid's like writing classical music and like this is like his classical instructor. So he's like, you know, it's the classical sheet music that the kid's writing, but he's really good at pop. Whatever. It's true. Well, T Swift is laughing all the way to the bank, so her strict master paid off. Oh, what does this one say? Interesting. That's like the play. Like bring in I think that's interesting. I like that, where it's like, you know, some sort of like external relationship that makes the music he's playing at the concert different than the one he's like writing with like the old man. Student forgives the master chancellor for fun. Concert he's doing later. Gotta love that. BB King knew his stuff. Alright. So, I think that's kind of the basic outlines of each. I can kind of talk through them just to kind of get some perspective here. So, in the Alchemist one, the assistant is, you know, so it's an alchemist works on his greatest innovation, the Philosopher's Stone, but realizes that in order to complete it, he'll have to use his own life as the final ingredient. So the assistant's trying to talk the master out of this. He's like, hey, we've been looking for this glass flower component for like forever, you know, but now that we're here, I just don't know. This doesn't seem right. You know, let's just go back. Like, we're making a good living at our place. Let's go back and just like get things back to normal. And then he's like, the master's like, no, this is the most important thing to me. Like, we're doing this. And then, you know, we kind of go into this like mysterious situation. He has, like, you know, he goes in and, like, the old man's like, oh, I hear you say, like, you have, like, the final component. Or, like, you have, like, you have a formula for the Philosopher's Stone. He's like, yes, I just need the flower. So the old man, like, picks it and puts it in and then, like, changes color. And he's like, why isn't it, you know, making a stone? Like, what's going on? And then he's like, well, like, the final thing is, like, is life. Like, you know, it's like... But it's like gonna go bad, like, you know, and it's like maybe the urgency is like, once the flower is put in, potion starts going bad. Yeah. And then he has to kind of make that decision. He's like, you know, it will kill you. Like, once you put a drop of blood in it, it's going to take your whole, like, it's going to kill you. But you'll make the, like, you'll be the guy who did it. And then the alchemist is like, tell people that I'm the one who made it. Like, tell them it was me. You know, tell people that I'm the one who made it. Tell them it was me. And then, like, the... And, like, but, like, his apprentice, like, cares about him and tries to use his own life as the catalyst. But the alchemist breaks the bottle and they get a better... So that's the alchemist one. I keep adding more, just talking through it. Okay. A great scene to shift from reality. Yeah, that's true. I think that's one of the ones I'm probably leaning towards strongest. It's tough, man. Like, these are, I mean, yeah, I'm kind of like on the fence on these. And if you guys are also, if you guys, you know, want to write one as well, you pick one of the, like, you know, you feel free to pick one of the ones that, yeah, is there a conflict with the flower? Like, it's rare or hard to grow. Mm-hmm. Yes, that is great observation, Judy. That I think the way I kind of envisioned it, with kind of Mucher had like a phenomenal idea too, kind of just saying, hey, like, this is like a, like this last like final magical component. It's really rare. Probably the setup of the story, that first like scene or so, would be like them like chasing down leads for this flower, being like, there's one here in the city today. We have to go right now and get it. It's the only one that I've ever, you know. So that's kind of the way that I envision contextualizing it, that makes sense. A great comment, but you're absolutely right. Like, you gotta have that conflict. You gotta have that, like, scarcity, or else, you know, you may not have a story. benefits, irony, guy dies, okay. All right, so then the other one was, so that one's probably one of the front runners. Managing partner of firm dies from overwork, leaving his position open. Two of his underlings vie for the job, not realizing that getting promotion could cost their souls. So the way this one plays out is like, you know, the really well-dressed old manager keels over at his office, or like keels over on the subway home. Some guy, like the protagonist, is like at home with his family, like actually, yeah, I don't like the song, sorry. Good band, but this is not one of my favorites. But yeah, so then it's like, you know, well-undressed old man working the subway. Guy gets his call at home. So then, like, he's with his kid. So, like, his manager, like, his, like, predecessor dies on the subway. He gets a call, like, at the house at, like, you know, 2 a.m. He's, like, with his kid. She's sick. And then the mom's, like, the kid's sick. And then he's, like, I gotta go to the office. The kid's sick. I gotta go to the office. You know. And, like, the mom's, like, but you have a job. Like, you know, just, you know, you can make money doing whatever. Like, this is your kid. And he's, like... Oh, like, you know, I just gotta go. And so he goes to the office, finds out the boss dies, and finds that there's gonna be one of the two. He's like, you know, there's a big promotion coming up. I can't blow this. That's true. I think, you know, one of the things that, you know, and maybe that's how we'll, how if, you know, this is when we go with, we bring in the dialogue, is to say, like, hey, look, there is that kind of, like, that back and forth, like, you know, conversation where she's like, well, you can get a job, like, you have, like, a really marketable skill set, you can get a job, pay the bills, we can just have, like, a normal family, it doesn't have to be you leaving at 1 a.m., and then he's like, I can't. And then he goes and he fails. And then at the end, that closing scene is like him leaving the office. And then like that kind of like sign that he's deciding to go back to his family and like, and then maybe it's like, you'll lose your job. Like, and like the manager's like, if you leave now, like I'm going to fire you, like blah, 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 blah. After going to, that's true. That could be like a really big like perspective, like, nope. Like, he gets hit by a bus right after he goes through all that hard work. That would be a bit depressing. I think, yeah, that would be, it could be poignant. I think it's like very ironic. Like, that's what people joke about at work, where they're like, you know, I'll finally make my million and then walk outside and get hit by a bus. Which is like, you know, what truly mattered, right? I think it's a very good observation for sure. So like the bus. Bus hit at the end. You can try cleaning like kind of new Jerry Maguire or Tom Cruise. Jerry Maguire. I've actually, like, and this is probably shame on me for not having done film. I have not seen Jerry Maguire all the way through. But I, it sounds like. I think I kind of know what you're saying, because I know he falls for like the Irene, for me, myself and Irene, but like, and that's why he quits his job, but my memory's fading. But yeah, I need to catch up on my movie stuff. So the guy gets called from home, he leaves, there's like some sort of competition that night where like we have, like, investors are coming in tomorrow. We need a VP of sales. Get a deck together on why it should be you and present to me by 6 a.m. That's true. And he's like, oh. And then whatever, he breaks up with the mom. And he's like, you're cool and all, but I just like hanging out with your kid because he's awesome. So you just go run along. And hopefully that doesn't happen. That would be like the darker side. Well, we should watch it, Foxy Lady. Let's do Jerry Maguire this weekend. I'm down. Young punk rocker saves his master. Okay. Young Pastor. So I'm going to probably lean against the young punk rocker. I don't know if that's the strongest as far as context and stuff like that. The conflict is not as clear. And, you know, conflict is story. Or he gets your job. You get a promotion or he gets your job. That's true. Like, what do you... Like, so he gets your job. Like, oh, like, oh. Either the guy steps up. Or he gets fired. I think I like that. Woo woo! Yeah, we can live stream watching Jerry Maguire. That'd be pretty epic. I think the man at the office. Yeah, I think that makes sense. Yeah, sounds like the common situation. This one sounds like a common situation. You have to make the twist really clever. The man at the office. Hmm. So, Judy, would you say that you're just like, yeah, I've seen this idea a few times before? Like, do you think this is kind of something that's a little bit too common, stuff we've seen before? The man at the office one? Yeah, I guess you're right. I mean, because... Yeah, I think the old guy dying is a bit extreme, but we've seen, like, the VP, whatever, get... You know, the promotion before and have to sacrifice for the kid. What do you think, guys? Should we nix this one and go for the alchemist one after all this time? I'm watching the comments. I'm looking for that final word here. I think it's too relatable. Could be a key to spinning this a different way. I think it's a special relationship between the characters. Maybe they're co-founders together. Yeah, Fox wants the Alchemist one. Neither the co-founders together, all brothers. All right. Gosh, I kind of like this one though. Potential cover stories. It's too corporate to me. Unless it's really clever. Yeah, I think you guys are spot on. I think it's something about the Ivan Ilyich, because that story just spoke to me a ton when I read it. That kind of dynamic is good, but I think you guys are making the right call here. All right. So I don't know if the music one has a strong enough story arc. I don't think this one is unique enough. So we're going with the Alchemist one. High fives, everybody. We did it. Narrowed it down to one log line after 11. Yeah, I think so too. Okay, cool. Well, then now it's time to work on a treatment. It's 11:03 my time. It's probably a little bit late. What do you guys think? Should we continue the struggle tomorrow? I don't want to keep everybody up too late, but, or we can at least kick off the treatment. We actually kind of have pretty much, I mean, it's a short little thing, so it's pretty much that bullet point outline would almost be enough. So then I'm going to copy this out. Oops. Progress. All right. So the new era begins. So we are doing the Alchemist storyline. 168. Kick it off. All right, so let's kick it off. And this is the way I go about structuring even bigger works. So I would actually kind of curious to hear you guys' thoughts on my process, since you guys have been amazing and kind of ventured forth with me on this one together. Yeah, and we can all sleep on the next step. Sweet. But yeah, so usually what I do is I go through log lines. I kind of... Yep. So what I'll do, I'll kick it off and then we'll go to bed before too late. So usually what I'll do is I'll try to write the bullet points, get the scene-by-scene outline, and then write a treatment about it. So that's probably what I'm gonna be focusing on with this one particularly. So probably now I'm going to do a scene-by-scene outline with each scene having the goals, the stakes, the urgency, and kind of like the basic structure. And then I'll probably write like a treatment of all that and then start on the first draft probably tomorrow afternoon. I may even like, if I have time to work on this during the day at work, sneak out for lunch break and stuff. So let me just, I'm going to rearrange the windows real quick just so it's easy to see what's going on. I'll bring the Alchemist over here. Uh-oh, I just blocked everything out. I'll just start with a blank page, and I'll just use it on my side here. And then I'll bring that up. Thank you guys for your patience here. Okay. Okay. Does it look normal? No. Okay. Oh my gosh. Alright, let me turn that off for a second. That's just gonna go crazy. Alright, in the store, the call to get the last component. And what I can do is, and this actually probably will be like how I'll probably do the stopping point. It's almost outline like one scene completely for today. And then, you know, hopefully tomorrow I'll have a more baked out outline that we can kind of talk through together. And then, you know, I'll probably be starting on the first draft. So, yeah. So then I'll kind of just show you what that first scene would look like probably. The two are working, doing normal business and lead. Needed isn't like not focusing on customers, but talking about, I think it's just. Just needs one thing. Like, one. The apprentice is doing all the work. The work master is off in La La Land. In the back, mumbling about how he's so close. Almost found a black tulip. Why is that so important? Oops, I haven't checked the comments in a bit. Hold on. Sorry. Take it easy, Judy. What would be a character out of place if the main character is laying in the dressing? Get a tip on the plant location. Oh, I actually like that. It's like, you know. Yes. Okay, I actually really. Jeez, thank you. I hope you have to like sign like a. Alright. Starts in a rave to get a lead. Tell me about the old man. How did he find it? Maybe it's like something crazy like only grows on corpses. That's like really grim, but whatever. Okay. That's like a bad thing. But you can't second guess too much in brainstorming. So I have the raw materials we need to make. So then after he gets that lead and like kind of like goes to this sketchy place to get it, he's like back in his store. He's like, okay, I have a lead. We're going right now. And he's like, but we have customers. Like, what's going on? Like, we have a lead. We're going right now. But we have customers. Okay, so this would be like, and this is how I would do like the scene. Which would be like goal. Get the assistant to get what they need for the stone function and I appreciate it. Moocher the beneficent. Beneficent? Beneficent. Yes. To get the assistant what they need for the formulation and get to the contact before he leaves. Yes, and then like when he's like putting it in, like it could like light up his face, and he's like, "You have to do it now." That'd be awesome. Stakes. The lead. A lead on a black tulip never comes. This is a once in a lifetime. Close the shop. And this is maybe where we could state the theme, and then this could be probably one of like the scene goals, right? Because then you have your scene structure, which is kind of like the goal stakes, and then the scene goals, which is like kind of the work it's doing in exposition, which is like communicate that they're alchemists, gently touch on theme, what's like, you know, what this really signifies. Gosh, man, my music is just going bananas right now. Ah, this is a good one. How many of you guys come to the store? I said, yeah. That's true. These crazy black flowers at the club last night. Could the call to action happen? Could a call to action happen in the store? I actually, like, honestly, I really like the idea of having him going into, like, a jarring setting first. And I mean, props to, like, your intuition. Because I think it shows that he's been pursuing this for a while. Because one thing that, like, when it's like this, when you have to, like, build up a thing to, like, this level, you have to show that, like, this guy has been, like, hunting it for days and days and days, and, like, this is, like, the last lead. And then once he got the lead, he's like, we're dropping everything, we're going to get this thing right now. This is our works. This is, like, our masterpiece. This is my work of art, like, you know. Gently touched on theme. We have a good business. Why shut down for some side project? Yeah, this guy stays tired and out of his comfort zone. Yeah. And then it gives that sense of urgency, and that would be like this thing here. It gives that sense of like the lead is the guy is only going to be here tonight. So then it makes that urgency really snap in like a store scene where we have to get more exposition across, where it's like, okay, well, I need to tell them that they're alchemists, which is like weird in the modern day. I need to touch on, you know, kind of some of like the, just like the bare bones of what people need to understand about the world. So hopefully it'll be like, come on, let's go. And like the assistant's like dragging his feet and like, well, what about this? And then you're like, no, like we need to get this right now. Like, but like the store's open, why shut down for some, you know, for some side project? And then he's like, side project. This is the only project. Who wants to just work for a living when you can work on something that will make you live forever? Your name live forever. That's actually good. I hadn't even thought about doing kind of characterization here. Shift Control B? No, this. Oh, no. I'm used to all the shortcuts from other apps. It's true, unless you're recording. Forever. It's the Philosopher's Stone. But maybe it's like the more gold. Huh. Yeah. Sancho Panza. The prince and Stephen said he gave the horse personality. That's very true, though. I've actually never... I think, you know, the token animals, like the talking animals and stuff like that, like those are just comedy gold in general. I should have a talking animal in here. His, like, magical dog or something. He's a termination incarnate. He wants to be great. Not just be successful, and his job is how he's going to do it. Those are just fill-in names. Yeah. Catch you later, Moocher. It's fun hanging out, dude. Or dudette. I'm actually not even sure. Maybe you specified earlier, but take it easy, man. Well, I think this is a good start. I'll probably sign off for the evening on this as well. I'm pretty tired too. And yeah, hopefully by tomorrow I'll at least have something like a scene-by-scene outline ready to go to start writing a first draft with everybody tomorrow. So that'll be fun. Good sleep. Good luck. Thank you everybody for tuning in, tuning out, hanging out. It was an absolute blast, you know, even if the story is total garbage, which I hope it isn't, but it's been really fun just hanging out with everybody, so worth. Take it easy, y'all. Have a good night.